What's up, guys? So today I'll do a full review of iOS 9.3. So I haven't been doing any videos on 9.3 since a lot, and since then, I mean, since the last video which I did on beta 3, Apple released two more betas, beta 4 and beta 5. So I haven't been doing videos on 9.3 since a lot of time. I haven't been doing videos soon, you know, 9.3. I'm sorry for this, you know, not doing videos on 9.3. But now I'm gonna do a full review of all the features from beta 1 to beta 5. And yeah, so I'm gonna show you all the features of iOS 9.3 till the current moment, because we might see one more beta until it's released. I'm not sure, but we'll see. So in this video, I'll show you all the features till the current moment. So let's start. First of all, we've got Night Shift. So Night Shift is a really nice feature in iOS 9.3. So that wasn't. And you can see the Night Shift is right there. Here it is. And basically, this feature turns your screen a warmer color, so it will be better on your eyes at night. It won't blind them with bright white light. And you can adjust the color temperature right there. You can set it to less warm or more warm. And you can see warmer temperatures can reduce eye strain. You can see some information down there. And also, you can enable this feature on schedule, which is the best if you're gonna use it on a daily basis. And the best option from here is not a custom schedule, which you can do, but the best option is set it from sunset to sunrise. So your phone will automatically turn it on or off when the time is right, without you needing to worry about it. And yeah, that's the best option if you're gonna use it on a daily basis. Just let your phone turn it on or off when the time is right, and you have a better experience on your eyes at night. So this is about this feature, guys. This is Night Shift, and you can actually enable it. I'll show you. You can actually enable it from your control center. There is a toggle right there, and previously it was a little eye which looked like a lemon. It didn't look very much like an eye, but now it is that sun solar eclipse thingy, which is really nice. I really like it, and you can manually turn it on or off quickly from here, which is very nice. And previously, there was a pop-up which showed you two options in my previous videos of the betas. You can see that when you press this, it gives you a pop-up, and you've got the options to turn it on for now or manually enable until tomorrow. But that's gone, and now it's much simpler, which is actually better. You can just turn it on or off without any pop-ups or options, which is good. I mean, keeping it simple there, that's good. Just turn it on or off whenever you need to do that quickly, which is really handy here in the control center. But actually, this pop-up has been moved here, as you can see, manually enabled to tomorrow. This option is here right now, if you want to enable it from the settings. So, really nice feature there. That's one of the biggest features in 9.3. Make your screen better on your eyes at night by using Night Shift. Awesome, really awesome feature. I definitely look forward to using it on the public version. So Night Shift is actually not available in no power mode, so just keep that in mind. So now when you put your device in no power mode and go to Night Shift, you can see that it's grayed out, you can't access it. And it says right here, Night Shift is disabled in no power mode. So just keep that in mind, you can't use Night Shift in no power mode. And actually, before jumping onto the next feature, I'm gonna have a link down below on instructions how to install the beta if you're interested in that. So just stay around to the end of the video if you want to see that. So next feature iOS 9.3 offers is notes protection, password protection of notes. So as you can see here, I locked this note, and you can unlock it by either entering your password or using Touch ID. And you can see this is just some random text. I used this node for this video, for the purpose of this video, showing you the node protection. And in settings, in the settings application, when you go to settings and go to nodes, you can see you have some options right there to change your password and enable or disable Touch ID for the nodes. iOS 9.3 now supports configuration profiles. So if you are an Apple developer and want to get the new betas OTA over the air, you know, just like the public beta, you can download the configuration profile from the Apple Developer Center there and use it, use the configuration profile in order to receive OTA updates of iOS 9.3 and getting the betas faster. But that's of course if you're an Apple developer and pay $100 per month. So the 1970 bug has been fixed. And you know guys, I showed you this bug that breaks your device earlier in another video. You can check it out. I will have the link on the screen right now if you want to check this bug out. But this bug breaks your device, and it occurred when you set your date, the date of your device to the 1st of January 1970, which I don't know what reason would you have to do this, but yeah, that was the bug. It bricked your device by setting date to this date, and now this bug is fixed. And as you can see, when you scroll way back, this is 2008, when you scroll back, it only lets you go to January the 1st, 2001. It will not let you go further, and even if you try all day, it will just not let you go further. It will not let you go any further. As you can see, I'm just scrolling right there and scrolling. And it will not let you go further. So this is fixed. And the Safari crash has also been fixed. So this web page, safaricrash.com, you will no longer be able to load that web page. The Wi-Fi assist feature now shows the data it has been using over cellular, the amount of data it has been using. Unfortunately, I can't show this to you right now because I haven't been using this feature, the Wi-Fi assist. But normally, if you go to... I have 3G, but I haven't been using the Wi-Fi assist feature, so if you go to cellular, the Wi-Fi assist, you can see it's enabled, but I haven't been using it. And it will show how much data it has used right there under the Wi-Fi assist here feature. So that's what it's gonna look like. I can't show it to you right now because I haven't been using it. So in iOS 9.3, in the watch application, you can now preview the current phase of your watch. So you can just see how your watch looks like. You can preview the current phase of your watch right there, and you can pair more than one watch, two or more watches now. But I can't show this to you right now because I don't have an Apple Watch. But basically, if you just go, if you open the app, and it's gonna show you your current watch face of your Apple Watch. And also you can pair more than one Apple Watch, two or more Apple Watches now with this app. Next on, we have new 3D touch toggles and main one on settings. And as you can see, you have options for Bluetooth, Wi-Fi and battery. And this is pretty cool. There are some new 3D touch toggles also on health, on weather, on stocks and on compass. Pretty interesting one right there, but it's there in Compass. Also on the App Store and iTunes Store, there are some new 3D touch toggles as well. On the App Store, you can now see your update all the applications and see your purchased apps. And on the iTunes Store as well, you can view the downloads and view the purchased apps. And the logos have been changed since the previous betas, and they're a little bit bolder now. And yeah, the logos have been changed too. So there is new 3D touch functionality as well for some apps that previously didn't have it. So as you can see here on the App Store, you can use 3D Touch on the apps and preview them and pick and pop into them if you want. And this is pretty cool. You can preview the applications without opening them. This is really cool. Another awesome 3D Touch feature, Apple is going up in the 3D Touch optimization in 9.3. So another 3D Touch feature right there is when you actually access your multitasking with 3D Touch, you previously field the haptic feedback and the taptic feedback only when you were peeking into it. You know, you feel the vibration there, the taptic feedback, when you're opening the multitasking. But now you feel two vibrations, on peek and pop. Previously it was only on peek, now it's on peek and pop. No, actually, sorry, previously it was only on pop, now it's on peek and pop. My mistake right there. But this is new as well. In the health application, you can now see health activity section, which is new. I haven't been using it, so I have no data there, but this section is new. And for those of you who use the health app on a daily basis, it will be a cool feature, I'm sure. So developers now can get rid of, you know, remove, or actually they won't delete them, but they will hide them, hide the stock apps, using a feature called the Apple Configurator. So using that, developers can hide their stock apps, and it's not easy, it's not user friendly, but it's there, and if you're a developer, you have that feature. In the Photos application, you now have the option to duplicate the photo, and you can see this is a live photo right there, but now you can duplicate it and also make it a still photo. Duplicate it is a still photo. And as you can see, I duplicated it, and now it's not a live photo, it's a still photo. So, nice new optimizations to the Photos app as well. On the private settings, you now have a new media library. And this means that third-party developers will be able to access your media library. So, third-party apps, I mean. And this means that third-party apps will be able to save music to your music library. Awesome feature right there, well done Apple. iBooks now supports iCloud, so this means all your magazines, books, PDF, and all the stuff you keep there will be synced across all of your devices. Pretty cool feature right there. The news application has been tailored to better suit your needs right now. And the news are better organized, and overall the application is tailored to better suit your needs. Also, you have new options when you swipe right or left. You can see there. And that's good. Interact with your news more. iOS 9.3 actually has education updates. So, if you wanna, I don't know much about this. If you wanna learn more, of course, go to the Apple website, the iOS 9.3 preview, and I'll have a link down below in the description to that web page. They have a preview there, and you can see more, you know, see more about this there. You now have the near you features for Maps in CarPlay, and also you have the new and for you tabs from Apple Music right there. And you can see all the features and learn more, of course, on that webpage. I'll have a link to it down below. And you can learn all about iOS 9.3 there, so I'll just leave a link down below in the description if you're interested to learn more. In Safari, a 350 milliseconds delay has been removed. Okay, managed to stabilize this, so let me go ahead and show you. I'm gonna do it with CNN.com, and here, and we're gonna press open at the same time, and watch. You can see this one loaded faster. It was obvious. So that's it, guys. So guys, thanks for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. I will leave the link down below on how to install the beta and also the official page of iOS 9.3 if you want to check these features there. And thanks for watching. Peace out.